Namaskarams, I am Keshav Murthy from Coimbatore. I am an HR cum educational consultant. In this video, we will look at a chapter called Direction Sense. Questions are asked from this chapter in various exams such as bank exams, NTSC exams, GRE, etc. So we will look at what we mean by direction sense and what are the types of questions that are asked. As we all know, there are four major directions, that is north, south, east and west. There are four more directions, that is northeast, southeast, northwest and southwest. So as far as our problem is concerned, there are eight directions. Now the angle between any two consecutive primary direction is 90 degrees. That means the angle between north and east is 90 degrees. Similarly, the angle between south and west is 90 degrees. Likewise, the angle between any two consecutive secondary directions is 90 degrees. That means the angle between, let's say, northeast and southeast is 90 degrees. The angle between a secondary direction and the nearest primary direction is 45 degrees. For example, the angle between northeast and east is 45 degrees. If we know this theory, then we can solve any type of problem in this direction sense. Now let us look at one problem and try and solve that problem in this video. Here, this is a problem where a boy Ramesh walks 5 meters towards east and goes 8 meters towards north. That is, he takes a left turn and goes 8 meters, walks 8 meters, and then he takes a right turn, again he walks 2 meters. So from the starting point to the end point, first he walks 5 meters towards east, takes a left turn and then walks 8 meters and then takes a right turn and walks 2 meters. Now the questions asked could be, one is, what is the total distance travelled by Ramesh? That is equal to 5 plus 8 plus 2, that is 15 meters. The next question will be, what is the horizontal distance travelled by Ramesh? It will be 5 plus 2, that is 7 meters. What is the vertical distance travelled by Ramesh? That is 8 meters. And the fourth question would be, the end point is in what direction with respect to the start point? Ramesh travelled east as well as north. So obviously the end point is in the northeast direction from the starting point. The fifth and the final question is, what is the distance from the start point to the end point, the direct distance from the start point to the end point? Now if you take Pythagoras theorem, then you can say the length from the start point to the end point is the hypotenuse, and one side of the right angle will be the horizontal distance, the another side of the horizontal another side of the right angle triangle is vertical distance. So the distance from the start point to the end point is equal to root of horizontal distance square plus vertical distance square. That is equal to root of 7 square plus 8 square. That is equal to root of 49 plus 64. That is root 113. This is also called as a crow flying distance. If you allow a crow to fly from the start point to end point, it will go directly. So that is why it is called a crow flying distance. So these are the five types of questions that will be asked in the exam, and it is not difficult to solve any of these problems provided we know the theory. Thank you, and I will meet you with another video on another subject. Thank you once again.